So, Mark Breland, you just did mitts with Deontay Wilder. I'm just watching and I can feel the power. What's it like to be on the absorbing end of these monster shots, the right hand that puts everyone asleep?
Scary.
Why?
Right there.
Has he ever missed one by mistake?
But I turned just in time. My reflex is staying. You can bang it. I don't want to hear it right now.
You've been around Deontay for a few years now. What can you tell us about him? Great person, good sense of humor.
This is a good person. Very dedicated to boxing. Very dedicated to what he's going to fight.
King Kong Ortiz, Deontay Wilder, I think three rounds. Is that, you think you're, I'm close or?
I said between one and three.
How about Anthony Joshua?
One and three,
two. Do you agree?
I agree.
Now, Mark, in the amateurs, you had so many knockouts. The amateurs don't get knockouts like that. How were you able to knock so many people out?
A lot of jabs, but knowing how to punch, you know. I used to spar with Tommy Hearns when I was 17.
That's crazy.
I learned how to punch.
Who's taller?
He's tall. Both of us were 6'2", but you know, he was so broad to me. I looked at him as small.
So what was it like sparring Tommy Hearns at 17?
Scary. The first time I sparred him, you know, I'm like, wow, oh, so we were in Vegas, MGM. So we sparred four times. The last time we sparred, he said, I got you today. I'm like, what you mean? He said, I got you. So I'm doing, I'm working. And he throws the right hand. I see it coming. So I turned. When I came back, it was coming. He's like, hold on a second. And when he hit me, he's like, wow. He said, you know, it was the thing where, you know, it's like, you're quick, but you're not that, you know. He said, it took time for me to figure you out.
I have to ask you a question. You grew up in the Tyson era. I mean, you knew him as a kid, I'm sure. Right. Lennox Lewis said that Mike Tyson would beat Wilder, and I said no, because Wilder's too tall, too strong. What do you think of that fight?
It'd be a very difficult fight for both of them. Because Deontay don't have nobody in front of him on this scene here. And now you start swinging and you're missing. You swing. As you're missing, Mike's throwing punches. Mike is slipping and punching. Most guys slip and they don't punch, they just slip. So it'll be a dangerous fight, both ways.
How about Lennox Lewis Wilder?
That'll be a good fight. That'll be a good fight. Because Lennox got a good jab. Deontay has a good jab. Deontay is very awkward. His movement is.
And the power, you can't teach power.
You can't teach power. And when he throws it, he throws it.
He throws, as they say, with bad intentions.
Bad at every point. Jab, right hand, uppercut, whatever he throws. But Lennox has a good jab. You know, he knows how to use his arm. So that would be the only thing that may give him trouble.
Okay.
Because he might hit him in the arm there.
We never saw this fight, but Klitschko Wilder.
Klitschko. I mean, Deontay. Too awkward. I think Deontay is too awkward for him. And hit too hard.
All right, there you have it. Mark Breland, one of the best ever, now working with Deontay Wilder. If you're Super Bowl.com, I'm going to subscribe reporting.